Israel, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad, Baruch Shem Kevod Mai Uto Leolam Vayed. Hear, O Israel, the Lord Ayah, the Lord is one. Blessed be the name of his glorious kingdom forever and ever. Amen. Hallelujah. And bless your name. The king is hallelujah on the sixth day, walking in the field with the King face to face. I am my beloved and my beloved is mine. I'm so walking in expectation right now because the King is in the field. The month of Elul, where you can just teshuvah. And we really need to walk in teshuvah of all things. Come on now. The word of the Most High Yah says to seek him first. The kingdom of the Most High Yah and all his righteousness, knowing that all things shall be added unto us. This is a time when the King is most accessible. Yeah. I'm talking about he is our tabernacle. He is our dwelling place. He's setting us up right now for the 10 days of Ah. Going into Yom Kippur. Having us to search our hearts now. Because come on now, there's no good thing in our hearts. And our hearts will hold on to things that our mind cannot forget. So we have to do is do some deep soul searching and teshuva to ourselves first. For not being able to let some things go. As we said on yesterday, when the Most High Yah, before he even created man, he created teshuva first. Because the Most High Yah looked into the Torah.
Yeah.
And he began to ask the Torah a question about man. And the Torah said, man will provoke you to anger. Man will test you. So therefore, these strict adherence, you know, justice that you have put in place, man will provoke you. And so the Torah of the Most High Yah, he began to say, well, then I'm going to have to put teshuvah there. The Most High Yah is gracious. He's compassionate. I'm talking about the 13 attributes of mercy. He was thinking about us before we even trespassed. He was thinking about us before we even failed, before we even, you know, sin to miss the mark, as some folks call it. But we know sin is the transgression of the law. The Most High Yah was already thinking about us. He had already placed teshuvah in place for us. Mm-hmm. So when he says, all the law hangs on this. Love the Most High, thou Yah, with all thy heart and with all thy might and thy strength. And love your neighbor as yourself. The Most High Yah had already put something in place called teshuvah. And so as we're walking in this teaching, the dynamics of teshuvah, it's amazing that we were not taught how to teshuvah. We were taught forgiveness, but we wasn't taught how to teshuvah. So in this season right now of Elul, this is the closest that we will be to the Most High Yah. Because this is a time when the King steps off the throne to tap you in the field, in your workplace. You do not have to cease from working and tap you on the shoulder just to have you to teshuvah, turn around. Mm-hmm. But in that turning, are you really walking in teshuvah? Mm-hmm. Teshuvah of yourself, teshuvah of others. You know, some folks, it's like, seem like it's kind of hard to teshuvah. You know, I was speaking with the Most High Yah on that on yesterday. And I was like, you know, teshuvah seems kind of hard when folks have, you know, cut you kind of deep. You know, folks have betrayed you. Folks have lied on you. Folks have disappointed you. But can you really walk in love? Because the word says that love covers a multitude of sins. You know, he was really getting on me yesterday because I was like, you know, folks done did some stuff. And he was like, well, my response to that is love covers a multitude of sin. So I'm not saying that things haven't been done to y'all, because y'all know y'all walking in a season where people have done some things to you. And the Most High, y'all say, I'm not denying that folks have done things to you. You know, I said in the word, offenses will come. So I'm not denying that things will happen with you. I mean, Yahushua walked with a Peter and a Judas. One betrayed him and one lied on him. So who are you? I was like, but he was obedient to the Most High Yah. So it's not about you thinking about what folks done to you or wanting, you know, not walking to Tshuva. It's just about being obedient. It's about taking the principle and applying it and walking in obedience to the Most High Yah. Wow. That sounds so easy, don't it? But we got this heart, you know, the subconscious. We got this mind, you know, the conscious. Then we got this flesh. Ooh, Lord. Come on now. Y'all got to help me out this morning, because y'all know y'all don't walk in some situations, or you might be walking in some situations where you're like, ugh, I don't know about that Teshuva thing. Mm-hmm. But it's not about knowing about that Teshuva thing when it comes to Teshuvering. It's about obedience. Wow. Y'all thinking right now? Because I know I am. It's about obedience. That's the only word I got for you. And that's the same, I guess, this whole dynamics of Teshuva. He's like, there's nothing else you can say, Dr. J. It's about obedience. All you got to do is walk into Teshuva. Just do it. You know, we're going to have to be like Nike this morning. Just do it. Oh, man. I hear you, Queen April. Application is key. Well, we know that well, don't we? We know that well. Come on, King Reynard. Good morning. It's so good to see you this morning. Bless you, King. It's about obedience. Come on, Queen Gina. And I'm standing with you, sister, and praying with you and lifting up your family. Just know whatever you need, I am here for you. I love you, loving on you and holding your hand at this very moment. Teshuva. You know, the hardest thing you have to do is, it's this feeling of, well, I ain't do nothing wrong. You know, folks did stuff to me. I ain't do nothing wrong. The Most High Yah is like, ain't about what you did. It ain't about you not doing anything wrong. It's about, can you Teshuva? I'm testing you right now. I want to see if you will keep my commandments, yay or nay. What? Now, how you going to tie that to the commandments, though? I'm trying to, you know, walk through the month of Elul. I am my beloved, and my beloved is mine. No, I want to see if you would keep my commandments or not. Because when you're walking in the month of Elul, it's a month of love. So I want to know if you love me. Ooh. The dynamics of Teshuva. If you love me. Come on now, Teshuva. That's part of it. If you love me, oh, I am my beloved, and my beloved is mine. I'm in the field face to face. But the Most High Yah has a question for you this morning. If you love me, you'll keep my commandments.
Ooh.
He don't put that on the table with Yeshua. Come on now, I need to hear you say it. You know, Dr. J, we're walking in the songs of Solomon. I am my beloved, and my beloved is mine. My beloved is like the road of Sharon. You know, y'all been quoting the scripture. Y'all been saying it. So now, studying the dynamics of Teshuvah, the Most High Yah has a question for you this morning. You know, you're having that hard time, you know, forgiving somebody that did something to you. You know, you're having that hard time of letting some things go. And all I'm calling for is your obedience. If you love me, wow, you'll keep my commandments. Huh? Oh, I'm talking to you. Remember, we face to face. You don't need to look to the left or to the right. We face to face. Come on, turn. If you love me, you'll keep my commandments. All right. There's nothing else left to be said, Dr. J. Ooh. We wrestle not against flesh and blood. Quit playing. If you love me, you'll keep my commandments. Don't you understand? I made you. I made you in my image, in my likeness. You have my attributes, my characteristics. I put something on the inside of you. Guess what they're called? My commandments. I wrote them on your heart. Ooh, you know that heart condition that you're trying to have. I wrote them on your heart. And on your mind. I put my spirit, my ruach. Remember that grace that I gave you, the enablement to do something? I put my spirit on your inward parts. And I wrote my Torah on your heart and on your mind. You love me, right? Yes, I love you. I am my beloved, and my beloved is mine. Why your voice getting kind of low there, Dr. J? I am my beloved, and my beloved is mine. We're just talking face to face. Sometimes, you know, you just won't talk about it. I put my spirit in your inward parts. Oh, come on now. You are without excuse. I put my spirit on your inward parts. And I wrote my Torah on your heart and on your mind. What you thinking about? Because the only thing you should be thinking about is my laws. I wrote them on you. And then I put my spirit, my ruach, in your inward parts. That's my covenant. We're in covenant together, aren't we? Yes, Most High, we are in covenant. And I'm a covenant keeping Yah, right? Yes, you are a covenant keeping Yah. And I show mercies to 1,000 generations to them that love me and keep my commandments. You know, you've been reading Exodus chapter 20 for like months now. We kind of, you know, we ain't reading it right now because we in the month of Elul where you supposed to be really showing me your love. That's why I'm saying in the month of Elul, you should be studying the Torah more. This is a time of study, and this is a time to be gracious. This is a time to teshuva. You should be studying the Torah more. Because if you love me, it doesn't matter what somebody has done to you. Because Yahushua was betrayed and denied. Huh? Oh, they were sitting at the table with him. You didn't know. They were sitting at the table with him. You know that Judas sold him out for 5 shekels of silver. And you know, Peter just was like, I don't know him. I wasn't with him. I don't know Dr. J. I wasn't with her. So you think he was the first one to be betrayed? Some of y'all think, you know, woe is me. Like he was the only one. How you know I wasn't testing you? You know, sometimes folks say out of their mouth, now if you just do this one thing to me, I can't forget that. Don't be telling the Most High, y'all, if somebody do one thing to you, you can't forgive that. Because he going to test you on that. What is your that's separating you from the love of y'all? Because you're going to have to move that out the way. We're in the field with the king, y'all. Whatever your that is, you're going to have to move that out the way. Why? Tell her why, Dr. J. Because we love you. We will keep your commandments. Obedience is better than sacrifice. Woo! All right then. Obedience is better than sacrifice. Don't sacrifice your heart condition because you feel some kind of way. And you feel you can't walk that piece of teshuvah out. Don't sacrifice and separate yourself from the Most High. Because we love him. We keep his commandments. That's the bottom line. So if you want this teshuvah, it ain't over yet. We still here. We still here. If you want this teshuvah to be amazing and you walk out true forgiveness, just love him. Just be obedient to what the Most High Yah is asking. Teshuvah, I came all the way off my throne to love on you, to walk you through this, to help you. If you have to cry as you let it go, cry. But you got to let whatever that is go. That's it. Whatever that is, you got to let it go. And you're right, Queen April. Feelings lie. But we ain't talking about feelings or emotions right now. We're talking about an actual, if someone has done something to you in this season of Teshuvah before we even got here, and you need to forgive that person. You need to forgive them. Like yesterday they said, erase it. Woo! Can y'all really erase some things that folks done did to you? It says, erase it. King Reynard said, that has given me tough skin. We just move on in y'all. I like that. Get you some tough skin and we just move on in y'all. Okay. Let's do it. Because we can do it together. One can chase 1,000, but 2 can put 10,000 to flight. Come on down, and unity is where he commands the blessing. And right now, if we are all on one accord, and we're saying right now, I teshuvah, and I'm going to let some things go. Whatever my that is, I'm erasing it today, and I'm letting it go. Sound good, don't it? Sounds so good. Y'all doing it? Y'all letting that go? Whoever that was, y'all letting it go? We're going to walk it out together. We're going to do it together. We're going to put this tough skin on, like King Raynard said, and we're just going to move on in y'all. Let's move on in y'all. Because we love him, we will keep his commandments. Now let's continue this study on the dynamics of teshuvah. But before I move on to this study of the dynamics of teshuvah, and since we're talking about the laws of the Most High Yah, and because we love him, we keep his commandments, I just want to honor Pastor Keith Wilkins and First Lady Charnette. Because Pastor Keith Wilkins threw up a question on yesterday. Can anybody show me in the scriptures where it says 613 principles? The actual statement, these are the 613 principles of the Most High Yah. So there was a little controversy in the comments. You know, some folks were saying this and saying that and saying it was a Jewish thing, and we know we don't study that way. So he was asking about the 613 principles, the commandments of the Most High Yah. So I answered that question, that if you look in the Torah, which is Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, and Deuteronomy, those are the laws of the Most High Yah. Now, because we were not taught the laws at all, we go back to teaching of the law. And if you look at America right now, everyone is screaming out for the laws. But for some reason, we were taught we're no longer under the law, that we have grace. But we have to understand that grace is the enablement to keep the Most High's laws. So it was just very interesting that he threw that question up. And so I had to answer it, you know, because when we're searching things out, just because you're searching things don't mean it's written in stone. You know, we have what is called progressive revelation. So we can learn something today and then find out tomorrow, like, wow, the Holy Spirit is taking me on a deeper journey. And what I thought I knew, I don't know. And so with that being said, after addressing that, yes, I am teaching the laws of the Most High Yah. And he was like, great, you're a great teacher, Dr. J. And you do know some of those laws. We can't do them now because we're not in the land. And I'm like, that is correct. But we have to be very careful when we're studying things out that we know what we're studying by the Holy Spirit leading and guiding us into all truth. Because we shall know the truth, and the truth shall make us free. And we are in this together. And so I look at different people that study Hebraically and their level of where they are. You know, the Most High Yah is taking them in a different direction. We all have an assignment, and we're on that assignment. But I tell you one thing, we all believe there is one Yah, and we believe that he scattered us to the four corners of the earth. And now we are waking up Hebraically to study out his word. Because his word does not return void, neither shall it be reversed, and it will do exactly what he sent it to do. So when you're studying, please always ask the Holy Spirit, is this what I'm supposed to be studying? Is this the right thing for me to be studying? And study that thing out so you know the Spirit have led you there. So I just want to say thank you. Because a good teacher and a good student is always asking questions. The Talmudim said to Yahushua, teach us how to pray. It was always a question. Master, why do you do things this way? It was always a question. So it's always great to ask questions. If you don't understand something, please don't just receive it. Ask questions. Go research that thing out. We can talk about it. Inbox me, be like, look, sister, queen, I don't understand none of this. And that's the way we walk together with this knowledge, understanding, and wisdom. Because that's what we do. Come on, Queen April said, they are right in the Torah. King Yahushua taught 85% of Leviticus to his students because they were babes in Torah needing correction. Thank you, Queen April. Very good answer. If they would really know that Yahushua was quoting Leviticus, you will get an understanding of the Most High Yah's laws, and we're going to walk in his laws and his Torah and truly get an understanding, because the word says through all your getting, get an understanding. I love it. I love when we can walk together, but we got some questions now. What is that? Because you know some things are tied to Jewish and Jewish things and the traditions of men. We don't want to walk in the traditions of men. We don't want to go into another commandments and dogmas of man. We only want to walk in the laws of Yah, period. We want to be biblically correct, not what man said, what the Most High Yah said. So thank you. As we walk in the dynamics of Teshuvah. Woo, Most High. How come lifting up everyone on Facebook Live this morning? The ones that are listening live and the ones that will listen to the recording later. You still have a standing on obedience. Obedience is better than sacrifice. If you have any questions about something that you should do pertaining to the laws of the Most High Yah, he says to you, if you love me, you will keep my commandments. Because I am the Most High Yah, showing mercy to them that love me to 1,000 generations. Of them that love me and keep my commandments. Ooh-wee. I'm not a man that I should lie, neither the son of man that I need to repent. My word does not return void, neither shall it be reversed, and it will do exactly what I sent it to do. Heaven and earth shall pass away, but my word shall stand forever. So you need to have a response to the Most High Yah this morning. Nevertheless, not my will, but thy will be done. Holy Spirit, Ruach HaKodesh, when I open my mouth this morning, let me speak with clarity in my voice. Let me articulate my words. Let your spirit, Ruach, open the understanding of your people that they may see. Let the scales fall off of their eyes. Let them have a revelation like they've never had it before. Being face to face in the field with you, it's about your Torah, and you're making your word more attainable, that we could understand it like never before. And I will forever give you all the glory, all the honor, and all the praise. And it's in the mighty, mighty name of Yahushua, I pray. Amen, 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 and amen. Good morning, Queen Doreen. I pray you are feeling better sister, standing in the gap for you. I'm here for you. The word says, if two or three gather together in his name, that he would be in the midst. The word says, if two touch and agree on anything, it shall be done. And I know I can't do nothing this morning without this word being established through the law, the prophets, and the writings. So the method style of study, it is a process of studying the word of Ahaya, Asha, Ahaya, which is I am. That I am in Hebrew, the great I am, the Yah of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. And we seek his guidance and live in a kingdom lifestyle. The Torah is the Most High Yah's teachings and instructions in 613 principles. It's where the Creator speaks, Mother. And then we search the witnesses through the books of the prophets, the Nevi'ims, and the books of the writings, the Ketuvims. Collectively, the Torah, the Nevi'ims, and the Ketuvims, or identified as the Tanakh, which is the Old Testament's proper title, and it's the only book that Yahushua studied in reference throughout the New Testament. 1 Chronicles chapter 28, verse 9. And thou, Solomon, my son, know thou that Yah of thy father, and serve him with a perfect heart and a willing mind. For the Most High Yah searches all hearts and understandeth all the imaginations of the thoughts. If thou seek him, he will be found of thee. But if thou forsake him, he will cast thee off forever. Today we look to the word mind, labeb. Mind, knowledge, thinking, reflection, memory. The Torah testifies, Deuteronomy chapter 30, verse 1, and it shall come to pass, when all these things are come upon thee, the blessings and the curse, which I have set before thee, and thou shalt call them to mind among all the nations, whether the Most High thou Yah has driven thee. The prophets proclaim, 1 Samuel chapter 2, verse 35, and I will rise me up. I will raise me up a faithful priest that shall do according to that which is in my heart and in my mind. And I will build him a sure house, and he shall walk before my anointed forever. The writings bear witness. 1 Chronicles chapter 22, verse 7. And David said to Solomon, my son, as for me, it was in my mind to build a house unto the name of the Most High, my Yah. We have completed the method style of study this morning, reviewing mind. First, we recognize the standard set in the Torah in 613 principles. Then we search the witnesses in the books of the prophets, the Nevi'ims, and the books of the writings, the Ketuvims. Collectively, the Torah, the Nevi'ims, and the Ketuvims, or identified as the Tanakh, which is the Old Testament's proper title. And it's the only book that Yahushua studied in reference throughout the New Testament. 5 a.m. prayer. What is in your mind as we are in day 21? Of Elul. Is your mind and your heart still at war with one another? It's time that we truly elevate our minds and be real with what is in our hearts. But ultimately, it's time to be obedient no matter what's in our hearts, minds, and emotions. Jeremiah chapter 51, verse 50. Ye that have escaped the sword, go away, stand not still. Remember, the Most High, Yah, afar off, and let Jerusalem come into your mind. Shalom Aleichem. Peace be unto you, 5 a.m. prayer community. The battle over our minds is truly key in this season of Teshuvah. Is your mind remembering and holding past wrongs against people? Remember, if you can't forgive your brother or your sister, the Most High Yah will not forgive you. Let's get our minds together in this season so that our hearts will be prepared for Yom Kippur. So now, are you ready for the word of Yah, the father of Abraham, the father of Isaac, the father of Jacob? Are you ready for the word of Yah, the father of Abraham, the father of Isaac, the father of Jacob? This morning, we are coming out of the Songs of Solomon, chapter 1. Come on now, it ain't nothing like the rehearsals of the Most High Yah. It's like this circle going on. And now we're coming back around to Solomon chapter 1 all over again. Where are you on the day 21 of Elul in the field with the king? I am my beloved and my beloved is mine. And the question to you is, if you love me, no matter what's in your heart, no matter what's in your mind, no matter who has done what to you, the Most High Yah is saying, turn around, Teshuvah. Because if you love me, you will just keep my commandments. And that's going to take your obedience. We're coming out of the book of the Songs of Solomon, chapter 1, in its entirety, and it reads, the Songs of Songs, which is Solomon's, let him kiss me with the kisses of his mouth, for thy love is better than wine. Because of the savor of thou good ointments, thou name is as ointments poured forth. Therefore do the virgins love thee. Draw me, we will run after thee. The king has brought me into his chambers. We will be glad and rejoice in thee. We will remember thy love more than wine. The upright love thee. Woo! Come on, Most High Yah. I am black and comely, O ye daughters of Jerusalem, as the tents of Kedar, as the curtains of Solomon. Look not upon me because I am black, because the sun has looked upon me. My mother's children were angry with me. They made me the keepers of the vineyard, but my own vineyard have I not kept. Tell me, O thou, whom my soul loveth, where thou feedest, where thou makest thou flock to rest at noon. For why should I be as one that turneth aside by the flocks of thou companions? If thou know not, O thou fairest among women, go thou way forth by the footsteps of the flock, and feed thou kids beside the shepherd's tent. I have compared thee, O my love, to a company of horses and Pharaoh's chariots. Thou cheeks are comely with rows of jewels, thou necks with chains of gold. We will make thee borders of gold and studs of silver. While the king sitteth at his table, my spikenard sendeth forth the smell thereof. A bundle of merit is my well-beloved unto me. He shall lie all night betwixt my breasts. My beloved is unto me as a clustered of campfire in the vineyards of Edid. Behold, thou art fair, my love. Behold, thou art fair. Thou have dove's eyes. Behold, thou art fair, my beloved. Yea, pleasant also our bed is green. The beams of our house are cedar, and our rafters are fair. Psalms chapter 27 in its entirety. The Most High Yah is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Most High Yah is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? When the wicked, even my enemies and my foes, came upon me to eat up my flesh, they stumbled and fell. Though a host should encamp against me, my heart shall not fear. Though war should rise against me, in this will I be confident. One thing have I desired of the Most High Yah, that I will seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Most High Yah all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Most High Yah and to inquire in his temple. For in the time of trouble, he shall hide me in his pavilion. In the secret of his tabernacle shall he hide me. He shall set me upon a rock, and now shall my head be lifted up above my enemies round about me. Therefore will I offer in his tabernacle sacrifices of joy. I will sing, yea, I will sing praises unto the Most High Yah. Hear, O Yah, when I cry with my voice, have mercy also upon me and answer me. When thou saidest, seek ye my face, my heart said unto thee, thou face, Yah, will I seek. Hide not thou face far from me. Put not thou servant away in anger. Thou hast been my help. Leave me not, neither forsake me. O Yah of my salvation, when my mother and my father forsake me, then Yah will take me up. Teach me thy ways, O Yah, and lead me in a plain path because of my enemies. Deliver me not over to the will of my enemies, for false witnesses are risen up against me, and such breathe out cruelty. I have fainted unless I have believed to see the goodness of the Most High Yah in the land of the living. Wait on the Most High Yah. Be of good courage, and he shall strengthen thy heart. Wait, I say, on the Most High Yah. Now let's talk about it. The power of Teshuva. What you say? The power of Teshuva. As for the wicked man, if he should return from all his sins that he committed and guard all my decrees and do justice and righteousness, he shall surely live. He shall not die. All his transgressions which he committed will not be remembered against him. Do I then desire the death of the wicked, says the Most High, the Eternal One? Is it not rather his return from his ways that he may live? Ezekiel chapter 18 in its entirety. Teshuvah is a principle indispensable to relationship. What you say? Teshuvah is a principle indispensable to relationships, indispensable to the existence of individuals living in the Torah. For it is impossible for man not to sin and err either by erroneously adopting an opinion or moral quality which in truth is not commendable, or else by being overcome by passion and anger. If man were to believe that this fracture can never be remedied, he would persist in his error and perhaps even add to his disobedience. The belief in Teshuvah, however, leads him to improvement, to come to a state that is better, nearer to perfection than that which attained before he sinned. That is why the Torah prescribes many actions that are meant to establish this correct and very useful principle of Teshuvah. Without Teshuvah, the world could not endure. Say it again, Dr. J. Without Teshuvah, the world could not endure. Without Teshuvah, man could not but despair, crushed by the burden of his errors. Torah is the foundation of the universe. It assures and sustains its existence. Teshuvah ensures its survival. What you say? I'm talking about the power of Teshuvah. Teshuvah ensures the universe survival. So the power of Teshuvah is overwhelming. There is absolutely nothing that stands in the way of Teshuvah. What you say? There is absolutely nothing that stands in the way of Teshuvah. The thread of Teshuvah is woven throughout the whole tapestry of Torah, of our tradition. It is not simply a mitzvah, one of the 613 channels to tie us to the Most High. It is a general, all-comprehensive principle, the backbone of relationship with the King of Kings. There is no sin that cannot be mended or remedied by Teshuvah. Teshuvah removes a burdensome past and opens the door to a new future. What you say? Teshuvah removes a burdensome path and opens the door to a new future. It means renewal, rebirth. What you say? It means renewal, rebirth. The Baal Teshuvah becomes a different, a new person. It is much more than correction, more than modification. Come on, Teshuvah. Teshuvah elevates to a status even higher than the one prior to all sin. Even the perfectly righteous are surpassed by the Baal Teshuvah. Sin is time consuming. What you say? Sin is time consuming. It is an evolutionary process. Man does not fall at once. Suddenly, he is trapped by one wrong act or attitude, often seemingly encompassed, which leads to another. When failure failing to recognize and stop this process, a chain reaction is set into motion and leads to the mirror of evil. Teshuvah, however, even in the worst of cases, is immediate. What you say? Teshuvah, however, even in the worst of cases, is immediate. Ba'ali teshuvah are explanatory. For in the span of one instant, they draw close to the Most High, more so than the perfectly righteous who draw near. Over the span of many years. As teshuvah is not a part of a gradual process in development, it is not subject to any order to bureaucracy or a normative procedure. It is a jump, a leap, a monetary decision to tear oneself away. One turn, one thought, and thus it affects even law, justice. When someone betroths a woman on conditions that I am Tadazak, a righteous person without sin, the betrothal is valid and binding even if he was known to be absolutely wicked. How so? Because at that very moment of proposal, he have made immediate teshuvah in his mind. The single thought, the monetary meditation of teshuvah is sufficient to move man from the greatest depth to the greatest height. What you say? Just one thought. Indeed. For the essence of teshuvah is in the mind, in the heart. It is a mental decision, an act of consciousness, awareness, commitment. Uh-oh, now y'all would talk something else about forgiveness. Oh, if you can't see a change, then they ain't change. Mm. Teshuvah is one moment, one thought, one change of your mind, change of your heart. And I'm so glad with the Most High, Yah, it's immediate. Folks, takes years to get over stuff. You still trying to get over stuff that your mama did, your daddy did, your sister did. Teshuvah is immediate. The nature of teshuvah. Where does the enormous potency of teshuvah come from? What you say? The nature of teshuvah. Where does the enormous potency of teshuvah come from? How can it erase the past? Change the present, mold the future, recreate, as it were, the power of teshuvah derives from its transcendent future. Like Torah, teshuvah preceded the creation. Morning, you ought to know about teshuvah over forgiveness, because yeah. It is a difference. Mm-hmm. like Torah, Teshuvah preceded the creation. It is not part of the world of creation, of a creative process. It is beyond time, beyond space, rooted in infinity. And the spree of infinity, past and present, fade into avion. Teshuvah is in the heart, in the mind. One thought of teshuvah is enough. What? One thought of teshuvah is enough. For thought, the mind is not restricted by the limitation of the body. The mind can transverse the universe in seconds. And the mind, mashavaran, thought, is man, the essence of man. Man is where his thoughts are. Fasting, self-mortification, may be means through which man expresses remorse. They may be acts of purification, of self-cleansing, but they do not constitute teshuvah. Teshuvah, ha shakal, penance, contrition to the sin, to balance the scales, is important. So is teshuvah hagadur, the volunteer erection of protective fences to avoid trespassing. Hypocritical reality may dictate such modes of behavior corresponding to certain forms of weakness. However, these deal with symptoms only. They relate to specific acts that constitute the eternal manifestation of sin, external manifestation of sin. They do not touch sin itself. They do not tackle the root and source from which sin grows. That root and source is in the mind and the heart. Ignorance, carelessness, neglect, wrong attitude, egocentricity, self-justification. Just as sin is rooted in man's will and mind, so must teshuvah be rooted in man's will and mind. He who sets his heart on becoming purified becomes pure as soon as he has immersed in waters of a mikvah. Though nothing new has befallen his body, so too it is with one who sets his heart on cleansing himself from the impurities that besets man's soul, namely wrongful thoughts and false convictions. As soon as he consents in his heart to withdraw from those counsels and brings his soul into the water of reason, he is pure. Note the analogy between teshuvah and the purifying waters of a mikvah. Teshuvah is more than a mikvah. It is like the sea, immersion in which also effects purification. A mikvah is subject to limitations of time and space. It is limited to a distinct location, a building, and is not always accessible or available. The sea, however, limitations is always accessible and available. If not in one particular spot, then in another. Teshuvah is like the sea, which is never bare, so that whoever desires to bathe in it can do so whenever he desires. The tragedy of sin is not so much the transgression itself to succumb to temptation, for there is no man on earth that he never sins. The real tragedy, the ultimate sin, is the failure to judge oneself. The failure to do teshuvah. He has left off the contemplate to do good does not a harbor evil. Better one self-reproach in the heart of man than numerous lashes. As the bacteria, poisonous and infections are eliminated, their symptoms and outgrowth will disappear as well. And as sins cease, sinners will be no more. Thus, teshuvah, the teshuvah that deals with the essence of sin, brings healing into the world. This is not to understate the external symptoms of sin. For with every transgression, man acquires a prosecutor against himself. The act of sin assumes reality. It clings to man. It attaches itself to him, leading him further astray in this world, only to accuse him later in the hereafter. On the other hand, everything is in creation is characterized in terms of matter and form, body and soul. The act of sin, its external manifestation, is the matter, the body of sin, which creates the karaga, the underlining thought, the intent, the will or passion that generated the transgression, is the form of the soul that emanates and sustains that body. Self mortification attacks that body and may destroy that matter. But only a change of heart, conscious remorse, is able to confront its forms, its soul. Only the elimination of the thought, intent, and desire that caused the sin will eliminate the soul of the karaga. And when derived of its soul, the karaga cease to exist. Thus, rend your hearts and not your garments, and return to the Most High, the Most High, for he is gracious and compassionate, long-suffering, and abounding in kindness. When rending the heart in teshuva, there is no need to rend one's garments. What you say? Thus, rend your heart and not your garments in return to the Most High, for he is gracious and compassionate, long-suffering, and abounding in kindness. When rending the heart in teshuva, there is no need to rend one's garment. Now, here are your next five principles under the third commandment. Principle number 267. You shall not eat any abomination. Deuteronomy chapter 14, verse 3. Principle number 268. You shall not eat any unclean animal. Deuteronomy chapter 14, verse 7. Principle number 269. You may eat every clean bird. Deuteronomy chapter 14, verse 11. Principle number 270. You shall not eat any flying, swarming creature. Deuteronomy chapter 14, verse 9. And principle number 271. You shall not eat any carcasses. Deuteronomy chapter 14, verse 21. Amen, 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 and amen.
Now connected to SBI.
Talking about the power of Teshuvah. So good.
Thank you.
Day 21. All praises to the Most High King. All praises to the Most High Yah. Day 21. I don't know about anybody else. I feel lighter today. Because who the Son says free is free indeed. And when you get an understanding, that's what I love about the Most High Yah teaching us on 5 a.m. prayer. He gives us an understanding of what we're doing. And folks ain't just telling you to do something and not telling you why. You know, folks would just tell you to do stuff and you didn't know why. You were celebrating things that you should not be celebrating, and you didn't even know why you was doing it. You just did it. Celebrating, you know, Valentine's Day, February the 14th. Ain't never did no research on it. Pagan. All those pagan things we were doing. Now when we look at the Most High Yah, all of his feast days are sacred. They're sacred. Because he is holy. He's sovereign. And when you know what you're doing and why, allude is preparation, going into the 10 days of Ah, going into Yom Kippur. So right now, the Most High Yah is inscribing. You know, when he took the commandments and he wrote on the tablets of stone with the finger of love, he wrote that. So right now, imagine you are in the same place, no longer on tablets of stone, but on tablets of flesh, and he's writing on you. He's inscribing on you. So when it comes to Yom Kippur, he's going to seal it in the book of life. He about to put a seal on you. But first he got to inscribe on you. Oh, you better stop it, Most High Yah. I am my beloved, my beloved is mine. And because I love you, I will keep your commandments and do teshuva. Wow. So good. So, so good. That's all I can say. Inscribe on me, write on me. I put it in your inward parts, Dr. J. Ooh, Lord. I wrote it on your heart and on your mind. So good. So, so good. Wow. Boca Toe, good morning to you too, King. Boca Toe. You know, I just love the Most High Yah. He will lead and guide us into all truth. You shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. Thank you, Yahushua. Went to hell, took the keys, and holds captivity captive. Thank you, Most High Yah. All praises to the Most High Yah. All right now. We're about to enter into some sweet Sabbath rest. We're going to be doing our Erev Shabbat dinner tonight. Please, if you can, join us at 6 o'clock. And at 6 o'clock Mountain Standard Time. If you in Mississippi, that's 7 o'clock. If you are on the East Coast, that's 8 o'clock. Come on and sit down at the table with us and open up the Sabbath. Hallelujah. 6 days we shall work, honey. But on that 7th day, we shall rest. It's a Sabbath unto the Most High Yah. And we remember his Sabbath and to keep it holy. Shabbat shalom. So get to the blog spot, get to Facebook, get to YouTube. It will encourage you. I love you more, Queen April. I love you, love you, love you. Oh, I love you. Bye now. So good. So good.